everyone. I am Daniela, and I am the SolidWorks and SolidWorks PDM SME for SPK and Associates. Today, we'll be talking about the infamous unable to locate the file message. So this pops up pretty often. This can happen if you have an assembly, a drawing, a file that references a part that's been moved, renamed, something's been changed, and that reference is now broken. With drawings and assemblies, it's particularly straightforward to relink or replace that relationship. However, in this case, this is popping up for a part, and with a part, it can be more tricky to remedy. So here we have the message, and I am going to go ahead and click Suppress All Missing Components to bypass. However, it is important to note that because this is happening at the part level, if I go ahead and use this part in an assembly or in a drawing, this message will populate for the drawing, for that assembly, anywhere this file, this part file is used. So it's really good to nail it down, take care of it at the part level, that way you can use it without this message popping up. So let's proceed. I'm going to go ahead and click Suppress All Missing Components for now. And let me click out of here. Let's see. So as you can see here, it looks like a normal part. While we saw that link to an assembly, there is no assembly referenced in the feature tree here, which can make it tricky to find it. I know from experience that if I see this question mark here next to one of the features in the feature tree, there's an outside external reference. So I'm going to click on main body, and now I'm going to right click. In the drop-down menu, I'm going to select external references. So you can see here, this part was likely made in context of this assembly using an edge. And that is why it is referencing this assembly. And this assembly can't be found because it is on a user's desktop. So rather than track this assembly down, I know this part file can be a standalone file. It does not need that edge anymore. So I'm going to go ahead and break this reference here. So I'm going to select the feature. It's highlighted here. And then I'm going to click Break Selected. There's a warning letting you know that it will be permanently broken. So I'm going to go ahead and click OK. And now I will click Close, and the status has been updated to broken. And now I'm going to save those changes. And now that should be remedied. So next time I open up the file, that unable to locate file message should no longer be there. And it's all gone. Again, this is great because now if I use this part in an assembly or in a drawing, that unable to locate file message will no longer appear. For more SolidWorks tricks and tips, please stay tuned.